Hey YouTube, this is Zach with Achilles Financial, and today I'm going to be talking about Spotify Technologies. And I think that we have a lot of growth opportunities, both in the near term trade as well as the longer term. All of this, I think, is going to be dependent on what we expect from the bond market this week. So last week, we actually had the 10-year yield sell off, which saw a pop in a lot of stocks that are in the growth market. And you can see that we didn't quite have that same expectation with Spotify. They had some of that Thursday run up, and then they traded flat on Friday. So what does this look like for Spotify over the long term? Well, the company has continued to grow very successfully. However, now we're still looking at a stock that's trading at $250 a share, which is still just higher than their low of $225 this calendar year. So this is still riding a monumental increase in the overall share value of the stock, where the company actually had a huge price increase. I'll go to the 3-year back in May of last year. Again, a lot of growth. Some of this was powered by their Joe Rogan news, where they made the statement that they, or Joe Rogan, is going exclusively to their platform, as well as just some of the fact that, again, during COVID, it was a huge boom in the expectation that people would be listening to music from home, listening to podcasts. And you can see that the company did very, very successful during this point in time. Again, nearly doubling in at some point in time, 2.5xing the stock price. So what we're going to be looking at is, from here onwards, are we going to see another run up, especially since we have seen other companies like Shopify and Nvidia, who have been growing incredibly rapidly, expand as well. So one of the issues that I see from Spotify stock is the fact that the company overall is not yet profitable. You can see that while that has slowed down in terms of what they're outlaying right now, overall it's still very expensive. If we look at the quarterly view, since they did just announce earnings a few weeks ago, that overall in the last quarter, they actually had their first quarter of profitability. However, they in the year prior were spending a lot of money, and we still don't expect that this trend of profitability is going to totally continue, because we still had a lot of stock options that were exercised, and overall the EPS was still negative. So we're going to be watching the company as a whole. The good news is that I don't expect additional dilution at this point in time, because if you look at the balance sheet, they still have an incredible amount of cash on hand. They have a owner who is been there from the beginning, an owner founder in Daniel Ek, who still owns about 18 to 20% of the total outstanding shares. He is heavily involved in the management of this company. So that's been really cool to see his continued involvement. There's also a lot of potential growth opportunities that we see associated with the stock in terms of podcast advertising, as well as the expectation that they'll get in a similar space that we've seen from Clubhouse, where they're going to have live audio capabilities. Because of the fact that they have such a huge audience, they have some pricing power associated with that. And the expectation is, I would be surprised if we don't see that breakout back from, again, where kind of we're at right now. We need some news to push this back up. You can see the drop right here. It was pretty steep, but kind of a 2-3 day drop, where it went from the levels of nearly $300 a share down to about 260. So I wouldn't be surprised if we saw that catalyst of where we go from 250 up to about the 260 price point. So there's a lot of potential to get back to those levels. From there, I wouldn't be surprised if we were able to continue climbing back to that 275. But Spotify, in my opinion, is one of the dominant forces in the music space, in the podcast space. And for that reason, I anticipate that they'll continue to have the growth capabilities to actually rise into their valuations. If you look at the company right now, their gross profit margin is very, very strong at 25.6%. But we want to focus on how can they drive total profitability, mentioning the fact that their net profit margin that they see right now is the trailing 12 months quarters, and the past quarter was actually profitable, so they may have the capability to break out there. They don't have a positive PE ratio because of that lack of earnings, but price to sales is actually pretty low compared to the industry, which is nice to see. And I think that we do have a lot of potential going forward to see some of this growth that you see here actually translate into the total company being able to continue to drive profit. The big thing I want to focus on is that revenue growth on a trailing 12-month quarter, as this is a massive company. They're no longer a small company that is capable of growing 30% per year. But the fact they're growing 15% per year in an industry as competitive as it is a really, really strong spot. One of the things that we can see about the company is they have a pretty low float. So they have shares outstanding of 191 million, which I understand the term low float can be deceiving. But in terms of the pricing power that they possess, we've seen huge block orders drive the stock price up. Now, admittedly, the company used to be a lot easier to move because they had less shares, and since they've done a few more share offerings, it's been a lot more difficult to watch that stock really fly. So maybe to say a low float can be a little misleading, but really what I want to highlight is we've seen the stock run, and I think that they still have the capability to do so. So the other thing that I really like about the stock is they do, generally speaking, command pretty high premiums on their covered call potential. So that's pretty cool to see. So all that being said, what I'm going to be looking at going forward is if we see the stock have that break to where they can go from kind of this 240, 245 range that they've traded in over the past 5 days to really have the capability to go all the way up into that 260, 270 range. Because I think that we're not that far off and there's a lot of possibility for them to be able to do so. Keep that in mind that I am by no means a financial advisor and this is all just my opinion, but this is a company that has a lot of potential and I will be watching them going forward. So if you found this content helpful, please leave a like and subscribe. Thanks. Talk to you later.